ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ओम शांतात्मानं प्रणतसुलभं सिद्धविद्याप्रभावं बास्वद्रूपं सुगुणनिलयं द्वस्थकर्मादिवर्गं प्रज्ञावृत्तं निजसमदृशं तारतं त्यागिवद्यं साक्षात् ईशं मम गुरुवरम् शिवानंदम नतोस्मी शिवानंदम नतोस्मी ओम अखंडानंद संबोधो वंदनात्यस्य जायते गोविंदम तमहं वंदे चिदानंद तनुं गुरुं ओम टुगेदर आप्यायन्तु ममांगानि वाक् प्राण चक्षुश्रोत्रम अथो बलमिंद्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्माः ते मयि सन्तु ओम शांति 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 So in this opening Shanti Mantra is a prayer for our good health and well-being so that we are able to study the scripture. Along with that it says, Sarvam Brahma Upanishadam Maham Brahma Nirakuryat Ma Brahma Nirakarot So Sarvam Brahma Upanishadam Atma Vaitam Agreheva Asiti Isha Vasimidagum Sarvam Same thing is being told, Purna Madaha, Purna Midam, in different ways. That alone is there, that Bhagavan alone is there here. You and me are not there. That is the message, okay? So it is like a dream that we are seeing that you are all here. I am there and you are there. Sarvam Brahma Upanishadam. So behold Bhagavan everywhere. Let us behold thee in all these names and forms. That is actually the Upadesha. Then let me not deny Brahman. We are now denying Brahman. We don't accept Bhagavan's existence. Do we accept? It's simply say Bhagavan's Kripa and all these things. All these things are empty words for us, okay? You have not really understood actually. One story they used to say that once one person was walking and he found one small parrot, baby parrot, almost injured by monkey or something and was lying down. So he picked up. It was very much injured. So he dressed that, put some medicines and kept it in a cage and gave some food. After some time, it became all right. The parrot became all right. So he's a musician. He used to sing bhajans. Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. The parrot also learned. So he will sing, parrot will also sing. Sometimes some people used to come to his home. So when they come, the parrot will sing Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. So they are very happy. So he's a great devotee. He's always singing Bhagavan's name. Even the parrot sings Bhagavan's name. So on one occasion, one Vikriti, a clever fellow came. He taught the parrot, Master, you have imprisoned me. Please release me. Give me freedom. Please release me. So the parrot learned it. Next time there was some satsang was there. So parrot sang Sri Ram Jai Ram. Everybody was happy. Then parrot told, Master, you have imprisoned me. give me freedom, please release me. So everybody looked at him. So he went, opened the cage and released the parrot. So what does the parrot will do? Parrot will run about and come back and sit there and say, Master, you have imprisoned me. Likewise only we say that, Bhagavan, I have surrendered unto you. Bhagavan, you are everything for me. And all these things are empty words for us. Like the parrot is such a stupid parrot. We are also such stupid people. Without knowing what it is, we are also saying, Bhagavad Kripa, Bhagavad Kripa. All these things, words. We have not understood what it is actually. What it is, I was actually going through this some of the shlokas of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And what a beauty, you know, that he is. That Advaita Acharya he studied. He was a great Advaita Acharya. What is his bhakti and all those things. So great Advaitin, and he became slow, great bhakta actually. So from he got sannyas somewhere in Gaya. And then I'm going to have a detailed study of now. All the slokas are very beautiful actually. One or two slokas I saw, very beautiful slokas, Sanskrit slokas. So I'm searching for that original Sanskrit text. So like that it is happening. So the first mantra is, one person doing sadhana for quite some time, he has done karma, upasana, etc. And then he wants to find out what is my real nature. So these sense organs are working. They are not working on their own. They have no chaitanya in them. So what is that chaitanya? What is that behind all these sense organs which make them to go to their objects? Ken eshitam patati preshitam manaha. Kena pranaha pratamaha praiti yuktaha. Kena ishitam vachamimam vadanti. Chakshushrotram kavudevo yunakti. Compelled by, directed by whom the mind goes to the objects. Directed by whom? Prana here means grana. Prana does not mean prana, okay? Chandogya Upanishad, prana means grana. Granendriya is called prana. So this nose goes to its smells, goes to its object. So what smell is coming like that? Kene shitam vacha mimam vadanti. By whose shakti, because of whom we are able to speak, who makes us speak, who is behind these eyes, which compels the eye to seek that. Like that, Shrotra. So who is doing all these things? Is there anybody else is there? Why this question is asked? Because there are people who are dumb. They have the mouth and everything, but they are not able to speak. There are people who are deaf. They have the ear, they cannot hear. And a dead person has got all these organs. Eye is there, ear is there, everything is there, but he cannot hear. So what is that behind? He asked the master, guru. This question was asked by a shishya to the guru. Then the guru says, Srotrasya, he gives the answer, Srotrasya srotram manaso manu, yad vachoha vacham savu pranasya pranaha, chakshusha chakshur atimuchya dhiraha, pretyasmal lokati amrita bhavanti. Oh, that is, what is behind this ear, what is behind this srotra, which makes us to function, which gives us the capacity to function. Then he says, Srotrasya srotram, it is the ear of the ear. Eye of the eye, mind of the mind. It is. Yesterday I told you, you know, that Shanti Ashram, the peace prayer, the word, the eye of the eye, and ear of the ear, prana of my prana, like that it comes, you remember? Shanti Ashram, Shanti Mantra, peace prayer. Like our universal prayer, they have got a peace prayer. Same thing will come. So he says like that. So why he has told like that? Because there is no other way of saying that. Shrotrasya Shrotra means what? Bhagavan is there behind, if I say. Normally we will think that Bhagavan, somebody else is there. That is why in the, yesterday I told you, no, that Dhruva, then he, in that first stuti he says, Yo antapravishya, pama vachamimam prasuptam sanjeevayatyakila shakti dharaswadamna, anyamcha hasta Sravanastogadin, Pranan Namo, Bhagavati, Purushaya. All these Chakshu, Mana, Indriya, all these things are used in the first Yoga. Check it. Yaha Antapravishya. So, that Bhagavan who has entered into me and making all these things to function, he says. Now, what will be think somebody has entered? Somebody has entered means he must have, he was not there, he was earlier he was not there, afterwards he has entered. And when we die, he will go away. And he is, who has entered in me? He has not entered in you. Somebody else has entered in you. That is our concept. So, whatever we say, we can't understand that. However much we describe Bhagavan, we try to understand it intellectually, one. Then we try to understand him, behold him with our mind. We try to behold Bhagavan. Who is Bhagavan? Bhagavan, like that. You will try to understand him through the mind. I want to see Bhagavan. You want to see him. See him like what? As I see you, we want to see Bhagavan. So we have got a concept of Bhagavan. However much we say is sarvabhyapi, antaryami, these sounds are meaningless to us. We don't understand what is antaryami. We use the word antaryami. What is antaryami? Antaha is there and yamayati. Antaryami means who is there inside us and controlling us. Who is controlling us? We are not able to know that actually. Because when we try to see who is that, we have already made it an object. Who is controlling it? He is there. He is only, who is that is not there. I am that actually. That I, what we say, it is that only. But we don't understand that. Okay? That Atma means, what is Atma? Atma we do not know. Brahmatma, we say, what is Brahmatma? What is Brahma? What is Atma? We do not know. To understand that, a lot of purity is required. Mind has to become totally pure. And it needs his kripa actually. Kripa of Bhagavan is required. Kripa of Guru is required. That will not easily come unless we totally surrender ourselves. And total surrender is not easy. I surrender. So some but kalakramena Bhagavan Kripa will come. So in this commentary yesterday I asked you, the Jubilee book, even if you read it also, Shankara Bhashya is there, Hindi also, if you read, you will read but you won't get the meaning. So he gives an answer, I will tell you. Srotrasya srotram manaso mano. This is the only thing. Manaso manaha. Manaso manaha means the mind of the mind. What do you mean by mind of the mind? Shrotrasya shrotra means. You see, Atma means Atma Shabdas. What is mean by Atma? Because of Antaratma. Antaratma. The Atma of that. What is that Atma of that? Without that, it cannot remain. Atma of a thing is because of the existence of that, it exists. Yasya sadbhave, tasya sadbhavaha. Yasya abhave, tasya abhavaha. What is not, if because of its presence you are there, and if it is not, you will not be there. Even this has got its atma. This has got its atma. The essence of it. Because of the existence of which you are remaining. If it is not there, it will not be there. Because of the presence of Bhagavan, you are here. If Bhagavan is not there, you will not be there. So, in the Shanti Mantra, you can understand. Apyayandu mama angani vaku prana chakshu, that we can understand. Why a sadhak should make a prayer? Maham brahma nirakuryam. Let me not reject Brahman. Why should that prayer be that you are all sajjanas, taken sannyas? Bhagavan, may I not reject you? Why should you tell? What is the need for it? Bhagavan, you give me good strength. I should be free from disease. All these requests I can understand. Give me sufficient money. Give me a good wife. Give me a good house. All these things we can understand. Why should you make a request? Bhagavan, I should not say that you are not there. Have you any time thought about it? Why should you make a statement, Maham Brahma Nirakuryam? Let me not reject Brahman. That means you are rejecting. Okay, otherwise you will not say. Give me good health means there is a possibility that I may have disease. That is why we make a request. Am I right? So we reject Bhagavan. That's what I want. So we reject nature of, in your case, sometimes we accept, sometimes you reject, you say. That is partially correct. But 100% correct is you totally reject him. We never accepted his existence. Once you have accepted Bhagavan, you have accepted it totally. Can you say that I believe in Bhagavan totally? In that case, I will not move from here. Let Bhagavan come and take care of me. It's not possible, you see. It's all his. I am not going to do anything. Let him take care of everything. He has created me. He will take care of me. Like that, is it possible? 100% rejection is there. We just say by words, I am very much devoted to Bhagavan. Bhagavan, you are my soul. Tomeva mata, tomeva pita. All these things are words conveying no meaning to us. We have to really weep for that, actually. We know very well from the Shastras and all these things that Bhagavan's kripa is there. But somehow or other, that faith that he is there is not there. We are rejecting Bhagavan every moment of our life. Once you accept, then it is finished. Then he will be always with you. This point we should think. That is why, what is the need for a prayer? Maham Brahma Nirakuryam. Am I right? Think about it, actually. So we are all serious people, actually. We have left everything and come here, taken cloth. So, Atma means, because of that, because of Bhagavan, this is existing. I am able to speak to you because of that. This is, here it is existing, it will be here, it will be a vacuum. So this is the only way to say, Manaso Manaha means, the Atma of the mind. Atma, my Atma, when you say, who are you? When I say that I am so and so, I am Padmanabhananda. I am identifying with the body. I am identifying with the body of the Atma. Atma of the body. When I say, I saw that, you are identifying with the Atma of the I. Yes, yes, I heard. I heard means you are identifying with the Atma of the ear. Okay. In the Shankara Bhashya, it is mentioned, and Hindi translation is, we will read, but we won't understand actually. No manaha. Manascha anyasya sankalpaitri adhyavasayitri cha sat na atmanam sankalpait adhyavasyati cha tasyapi brahma atmedi. You have seen? Tasyapi brahma atmedi. Tasyapi brahma atmedi. Tasyapi atma brahma iti. That's the mean that you should take like that. Even the atma of the mind is manaso manaha. So the atma of the mind makes it to go. The mind, I cannot go there. When I look at you, the eye does not fall on you. What falls on you? The consciousness. That only falls on you. An object is, what is an object? Prakashakriya sthitishilam bhuta indriyatmakam drishyam. Prakashakriya sthitishilam bhuta indriyatmakam. Bhuta means pancha bhautika vastu. Whatever I say, I see you. I don't see you, your atma. I see you, the bhautika. What is bhautika here? Pancha bhautika sharira. Bhuta indriyatmakam. My eye, my indriya, my panchabhuta does not come in contact with your panchabhuta. When I see you, I see your panchabhuta only. I don't see your atma. Okay. And which see that atma? My indriya sees actually. Bhuta indriyatma. That indriya is atma of this. Atma of that indriya is? The atma of the eye is the aya indriya, sravanendriya. Atma of the indriya is the devata, chakshur devata. The devata's atma is paramatma. That is only paramatma. You understood actually. Paramatma has become the devata. Devata has entered here as the indriya, chakshur indriya. And Chakshurindriya only falls on you. If the Chakshurindriya is not there, I will not be able to see you. Are you able to follow? Let's make it little Sanskrit. Without the Sanskrit terminology, I will not be able to say it. So it is Atma, the Atma of everything, he says. That is the only way we can say. The Paramatma only goes through this eye and makes see all these things. Okay? So that is told there. Sotrasya Sotram. Manaso mano yadvachoha vacham sau pranasya pranaha chakshushas chakshuhu atimuchya dhiraha pretyasman lokati amrita bhavanti. Having understood that, atimuchya dhiraha, having understood that means, then once you understand that, all the yeshanas will be, all desire to hold anything will go away, because you don't see anything other than that. If you understand that, then what will happen? Manaso manaha. That is Paramatma only. That Paramatma, what he is there to see? He can only see that. There is nothing other than that. So adimuchya dhiraha, going beyond everything, means going beyond all these worldly things. Yeshanatra eva muktahasan. Pretya asmal lokati pretya, leaving this world. Amrita bhavanti. He becomes amrita. He becomes immortal. Once you realize who is functioning through this eyes, then you understand that alone is here. Then you will find that is tatabam. Maya tatamidam sarvam. Once you see that, then that will find maya tatamidam sarvam jagad abhyaktamurtina. Okay? All are very serious. Eh? So then he makes, how to find out? Okay, very, very goodly. I asked you what is the, what makes you to go there, means you say manaso manaha. If you told like that, I can't understand. Can you explain this little more? He says. Then he explains. Na tatra chakshur gacchati, na vak gacchati, no mano, na vidumo, na vijanimo, yadetati anishishyati, anyadevatati vididati atho avididadati, iti shushruma purvesham, ye naha tati vyacha chakshire, ye na yenastadi vyacha chakshire. So that which compels, which makes the eye to move to the object, that Paramatma, na tatra chakshur gacchati, I will not go there. I cannot behold that. Na tatra chakshur gacchati, na vak gacchati. I cannot perceive that. That is why Bhagavan says, divyam dadamite chakshuhu pasyame yogamaishwaram. Bhagavan has to give the Divya Chakshu to Arjuna to see that. Divyam dadamite chakshuhu pasyame yogam aishwaram. Aishwaram yogam pasya. What is aishwarya yoga? Maya tadamidam sarvam is the yomam pasya di sarvatra sarvam chami pasya di is the yoga. Aishwarya. Okay? So na tatra chakshur gacchati, na vaku gacchati. Words will not explain that. Yato vacho nivartante apraapya manasasaka. All these mantras, same thing only. Na vak gacchati, no manaha. mind will not go there. Navidmaha, we do not know. We do not know what it is. He says, we do not know. Navijanimu, yatedad anishishyat. How to teach you this that we do not know? How to explain it? Katham iti anishikshanam katham. Yata yatad anishishyat. How to explain this? How to teach you? How to make you understand that we do not know? That is how, and our teachers have told, anyadeva tati viditati ato aviditati. It is different from the known and the unknown. What is, do you know this? I ask you, do you know this? Yes, I know. Either you will say, I know. Otherwise, no, no, I do not know. Suppose if you say, do you know that? Yes, I know. So this is something different from known. Different from known means what? Unknown. Okay. Anyadi means not. Do you know this? Do you know? No, I do not know. I do not know means what? So that is different from the known. So different from the known means unknown. Okay. Different from unknown. So, don't you know this? Yes, I know. So different from the unknown means known. Different from the known means unknown. But only two are there. Either you know it or do not know it. If you know it, the other is unknown. If you do not know it, it is known. So this is different from the known and the unknown. Different from the known and the unknown. What? How do you explain that? You all studied, huh? Bhagawan is there. Okay, we all believe. Bhagawan is there. Bhagawan is there. You, how do you believe? What makes you to believe? Bhagawan is, we believe that Bhagawan is there. What made you to believe? You have not seen that. Do you know Bhagawan? No, I do not know. I do not know. But you believe it is there. So known means, what is known? All our knowledge is pramana. Pramana means what? Indriya gojara. What is seen through the sense organs is known. All our knowledge is pratyaksha pramana only. Okay? Otherwise anumana. So what is, this is here. This is known. It is a pratyaksha pramana. Whether it was there, I do not know. That way, pratyaksha pramana was not there. So, pratyaksha pramana, either it is bhava we have seen or abhava we have seen. Abhava also says it was not there. I do not know. So, this is different from this. This cannot be known by direct perception through the sense organs, nor you can do by inference. One tree is there. It must have come from a seed that we can know. Water is given if it is hot. It is, they have boiled it. So anumana pramana. So pratyaksha pramana and anumana pramana all are through the sense organs. This is not amenable to sense organs. Then how will we know? Pratyaksha anumana? Pratyaksha anumana agamaha. Agama means what? Something come from the guru. Somebody who has knows about it, they tell. Shastra vakya. Veda says Bhagavan is there, Atma is there. Guru says, you are not this body, you are the mortal Atman. So it can be known only through agama pramana. It is not, you cannot verify that with the sense organs. It is not an indriya gojara vastu. It is not an indriya gojara vastu. So it is not a pratyaksha pramana. So you cannot do inference. So it is different from known and unknown. Known and unknown are within the range of indriya pramana. Okay? Known and unknown are through the indriya pramana only. So this is not according to indriya pramana. It is agama pramana. So this is how. Ye nastati tati vyaja chakshire. our gurus have told this. So it is agama pramana. So this existence of this atma, paramatma in us, the Bhagavan in us, can be understood only through guru vakya, shastra, through from the shastras, guru vakya. That is why shastreshu, guru vakyeshu, satyabuddhyavataranam, yasmat karanadi. It is not a pratyaksha pramana. It is not an indriya gojara. It is agama is the only pramana. Agama pramana only is there. That is why it has to be accepted. Like, okay. It is mentioned here, all these things. Single word is there. So, tatra chakshur gacchati, navag gacchati. Nothing, none of these sense organs will go there. Therefore, it is not a direct cognition through the sense organs. And it can be, therefore, we cannot say whether it is known or unknown. What is told as known or unknown are indriya gojara knowledge. This is different from that. Therefore, it is different from the vidita, known, and different from avidita, unknown. This is how it is to be taught. Iti shushrama purvesham yaha naha tat vyaja chakshire. So our elders, our gurus have told that it is different from what you know and also different from what you do not know. It is you only. It is the Paramatma. It is your own self. It is Bhagavan. Vadantita tattvavidas tattvam yajnanamatmayam brahmedi paramatmedi bhagavan iti shabdyate. You call it as Bhagavan or Paramatma or Atma, Brahma, whatever it be the shabda. So that one. Okay. Then he says, he explains this. Yadvacha anabhyuditam yena vak abhyudyate tadeva brahmatvam vidhi nedam yadidamupasate. Yadvacha anabhyuditam, that which cannot be explained by the words, that which cannot explain it, it cannot be explained by the words. Yena vak abhyudyate, the vak prakasha, the vak comes, the speech comes, the prakasha, that is, vak prakasha is there, vak shakti is there, because of that, because of which this vak shakti is there, which vak cannot reach, the words cannot reach there, but because of which the words come. Tadeva brahmatvam viti, that you understand the Brahman, your Atma. Where the words will not reach, words which cannot explain, words cannot throw light on that. At the same time, that only makes the words to come out. That only helps you to speak. That you understand as that Supreme Reality, Paramatma, Bhagavan. Na idam, yadu idam, nedam, yadidam upasate. Yadu idam, idam idam shabdena upasate, tatu na. Idam idam shabdena yadu upasate, tatu na. This means what? This means are all indriya gojara. This means that is also there. You are there and that is there. It is something different from you. Okay, this means something other than me is a panchabhuta vastu. And I am different from that. So that is not what you do, upasana, this. So that is why in the Chandogya Upanishad, what is that upasana we do? I am doing Aditya upasana. Oh, okay, very good. You will have this benefit. Finally, he says, murdhate vibhidishyati. Head will fall down. You will do these benefits, you will get, but ultimate goal you will not reach. Your head will fall down. Murdhate vibhidishyati. First, when we hear, what is it? Why do you tell all these things we think? You won't reach the highest goal. Something will be there. We are all happy now. Because of something is there. But that, what you are destined that you are not getting, you have to get 100, you are getting 20 only. You can get 100, but you are getting 20 or 5, 6 like that. So, like that one by one mantra says, yad vacha anabhyuditam, words cannot explain this. Yena vak abhyutyade, vak is possible, you are able to speak because of that. Tadeva brahmatvam vidhi, that you understand the Supreme Reality, Bhagavan, Brahma. Na idam, yadid upasate. not this upasana what we do. Whatever we do as idam, this, that upasana is little less than that. That is why avidyaya vidyamcha vidyamcha estadvedo bhayam saha avidyaya amrityam kirtu avidyaya amrtam ashnute andandam apravishandiye vidyam upasate tato bhuye andandam apravishandiye avidyam upasate tato bhuye ipate evu vidyaya gumrataha. So vidya upasana also you will enter into andandamaha. Why? Because upasana also idam iti upasana. That is why in the temples, in the pujas, first is prana pratishta. You know, we take the Bhagavan from here and establish there. And the first puja is, puja in temples, first puja, you know what is the first puja? At the opening of the puja, puja is Atma puja. Atma Nirmaha Paramatma, first your own puja. And then the Murti puja. If you do a puja on the lamp or anything, in the permanent temples, this prana pratishta will not be there because already prana pratishta has been done permanently. Temporary puja. You never we do a puja on a picture. Picture you cannot do puja. And in the, also tie you cannot do puja. You can do, but it's not a shastrakta puja. Any puja should be done where? Either a lamp or that is fire or water. Puja will be always on water or fire. The earth we can't do puja much. Earth, water, fire. Air we cannot do puja, akasha we cannot do. So these two, panchabhuta two only. So they keep a part of water and do japa. That is why they keep a part of water and then pour water over that, this coconut and all these things. They make a paraphernalia. What is this? They don't understand. Puja is on the water only, Gangajal, any water actually. Varana mantra. Apohishtamayobhuvastana bhurjedadadana mahiranaya. All these mantras are on the puja, are in a lamp. The lamp. So there first you have to do the prana pratishta. Whatever devata we are doing, upasana, whichever it is, whether it is Shiva or Vishnu, then the dhyana shloka. Then from the breath you have to take. And pratishta, and then yatastanam pratishta bayami, then you have to send him back also. In heaven also, in the fire, you have to invoke him first. Asmin agnav, narayanam jhayami avahyami. Then you have to bring him there. So puja, here it is puja. So that Bhagavan only gives you the word to speak, to hear, to smell. He is the Atma, he is the Chakshusha Chakshuhu, Shrotrasya Shrotram, Manaso Manu, Vachoha Vacham. And these words cannot do that because it is, you suppose if you are a good jumping man, Gurudev says, acrobat, he will jump nicely, good. Gymnast. He cannot jump on his shoulders. You can jump on somebody's shoulder, but not on his own shoulder. Okay? Gurudev says, how much good or big may be an acrobatic or a gymnast, he cannot jump on his shoulders. So the mind cannot reach there because of that mind functions. So then one by one he says, Yan manasana manute yena hurmano madam tadeva brahmatvam vidhi nedam yaditam upasate in manasana manuti. The mind cannot contemplate on that. Manasayeva bodhavyam, this is actually. Yatra natatra gacchati, what is that? Natatra, the other one. Eto vacho nivartanti aprapya manasasaha. That is different. Aprapya manasasaha. So here, aprapya manasasaka, manasayeva bodhavyam. Manasayeva bodhavyam means because of contemplation, mind will become zero one day. So then manasana manute, which mind cannot contemplate. Yena mano, yena ahur mano matam, because of which the mind is able to contemplate. The mind cannot contemplate that, but because of that the mind is contemplating. Tadeva brahmatvam vidhi nedam yajitam upasate. Not what you do upasana, this. So it is that because of which my mind is. What is the cause for the mind? That is why when the mind settles, you are one with that. That is why all the sense organs should be withdrawn for what? If the sense organs are active, it will go outward only. So what we do, we even in temple, we go and close our eyes. Why? We are withdrawing and going to see what is behind the eye. We see Bhagavan there, and then everybody knowingly or unknowingly, nobody knows the Upanishad, but they will close the eyes. That knowledge is there. Those who are, some lady comes, she doesn't know this kind of Upanishad, but she will also, Bhagavan, please bless me. Why they close their eyes? Who told them to close the eyes? Anybody has told them to close the eyes and meditate? No, they just do it. You also do it. So we close the eyes and try to see what is behind the eye, what is behind the eye, what is behind the mind. Naturally happening, because you are that, Bhagavan has given you that blessing. One day I will make you do it fully. Keep on doing this, he says. Okay? So now, similarly, 3-4 mantras that we will see tomorrow. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.